Noise for Ben. Alright, so Ben's talked a little bit about paper. I want to talk a bit about plastic, yeah? See, one of these bottles, I had the idea for this when someone told me that they're going to last for like 1,000 years, so it kind of staggered me thinking that one of these, is going to like outlive us all. We'll all be long gone, buried, burnt to a crisp, and this will still be floating about on the planet, so I figured, what would a bottle's life be like? In the first chapter, I was manufactured. My plastic body filled with spring water flow that was captured. Across my navel, a label was plastered, so my name would spell naive if you read it backwards. And that's what I classed the lad as, who grabbed me at his local Asda as he dashed me in a basket with some pasta, cheese and crackers. After all, he had clean water from his tap, so bought me when he didn't even have to. Now this lad was called Steve, and Steve was a rapper. He had finesse with words. He wasn't as stupid as I'd guessed at first. And he was guesting at some dirty, dingy club that night. So I spent it stuck between his jacket and his sweaty shirt. Eventually he got on stage and dropped a heavy verse. I saw his lips were ready pursed before he tilted me and quenched his thirst. Now Steve had always been taught to respect the earth. Always recycled, cycled to work and fed the birds. So he shoved me in his pocket to reuse me. Peeled my label off so I was nude and you could see right through me. He never threw me away. Treated me like royalty. Truly spoiled me with dishwater jacuzzis. But I knew in due time that he would lose me. One Tuesday on his way to work, I was hanging loosely from his backpack. He'd left unzipped. I slipped, picked up by a cow to work. I bunged into a black bag, then slung into a skip. I was created, used and left to waste. Always dreaming of the day I'd reach my final resting place. An estimated 1,000 years is what I'd been given before I'd disappear. Now listen here, that skip reeked. And all I'd dream about in my sleep was the landfill, surrounded by mountains and creeks. One night I heard a noise, saw a snout and some teeth. It was a fox who ripped the bag and tipped us out on the street. To my relief, our encounter was brief. All he did was sniff about, but there was nothing he could eat. So we retreated, then I was kicked around for a week. Knocked about town, pounded by thousands of feet. High heels, cleats, trainers, Doc Martens and Tims. From the classy and prim to the scallies and crims, I saw it all. But to get back on the track where I'd been, all I needed was someone to put me back in a bin. I recall clouds blacker than sin. The night I met this lad down the back alley who looked pallid and thin. What happened was grim. He twisted off my cap to begin. Pulled out a rusty jackknife and started stabbing my skin. Crammed aluminium foil in my wound. Poked some holes in it. Lit up a crack rock. Intoxicating me with smoke that rose from it. I saw him overdosing on that coke and baking soda mix. Then watched him lying motionless, comatose with foaming lips. But when dawn came, he awoke from it. Looked at me and said, "Holy shit, I've just seen the Holy Ghost and been told to quit. I'm ready for a new beginning." Staggered over to the canal and threw me in it. I was created, used and left to waste. Always dreaming of the day I'd reach my final resting place. An estimated 1,000 years is what I've been given before I disappear. Now listen here. I used to contain water, now water contained me. For over a century I sailed the seas. I used to contain water, now water contained me. For over a century I was a slave to the waves that carried me. Carrier bags and other plastic debris sporadically passing me, cursed with the same fate. I travelled the English Channel, Atlantic and the Caribbean Sea, where a sea turtle tried scranning me. I got stuck in his throat. I was helpless as he suffered, spluttered and choked. With me lodged in his gullet would float for 7 days before we were hauled up on a boat. I was pulled from his mouth by this muscly bloke. He threw the turtle's body back, sadly stating another one croaked. Crammed me in a bag with masses of plastic rubbish and rope. Then him and his buddy lit up some bud and they spoke about how the ecosystem couldn't cope. I listened as the ocean swallowed the sun and stars started to glisten. I realised the nature of their expedition. The next day, I left with them. Still within the brimming bag of waste, we arrived at the place even more beautiful than I'd envisioned. The landfill. No longer would I be imprisoned. Amongst my kin I was immersed. We remained till flames liberated us from this earth. I was created, used and left to waste. Always dreaming of the day I'd reach my final resting place. An estimated 1,000 years is what I've been given before I disappear into the atmosphere. Nice one. Thank you.